Hey there, surfers. Today I wanted to look at the story that's going around now that veteran vlogger and YouTube star Casey Neistat has done a little talking about his deal with CNN. And if you think about it, right? The deal is that he is going to have his own little sort of news network channel here on the web. So if you think about that, it would be the Casey Neistat News, right? Casey Neistat News, which is also CNN. So CNN, CNN, hey, it fits. Was that their reason for making the deal they made with him? Probably not, but hey, it's just pretty coincidental. At any rate, I think it's cool because Casey Neistat did an interview with The Hollywood Reporter in which he kind of explained a little bit what he wants his collaboration to become. The Hollywood Reporter says, Neistat, 35, reveals he's planning a new Stella-named YouTube channel set to launch in March, where he will host a daily show. And the team behind Beam, which is his company, which was also purchased by CNN, is hard at work developing new apps that experiment with how to distribute the news. It speaks to CNN's fearlessness that they're willing to get behind radical experimentation in the media space, says Neistat, who spoke with The Hollywood Reporter about how technology can change the news and why this venture won't have a splashy launch. Well, I'm going to get back to that in a second because it's not as though it's a path that hasn't been trodden before. I mean, new media, new journalism, it's at the core of what the web was supposed to be and really hasn't yet. At least, you know, in the way that I think a lot of people had hoped it would, the way I hoped it would, because I myself have been at this for a while. I was a freelance writer before there was a web, and once that happened, I tried my hand at blogging for a while, and while I was playing with the electrolysis of water, interestingly enough, because alternative energy has always interested me, and hydrogen energy, in particular, at that period, I took a big interest in. So I thought, well, here, I can do some actual hands-on experimentation. And at any rate, based on all that, I got a blog going about that stuff, and it was the first time I made money on the web. I made, I think, $300 in a month. Just from Google AdSense. So I was like, oh wow, I can make money at this. Awesome. And I don't need to sell my soul to a publisher in order to do it, because that was one of the things that always kind of held me back, was I wanted to be independent. I wanted to do what I wanted to, when I wanted to. And I really, you know, I didn't realize it when I was younger, when I should have realized it, that I wanted to be a globe-trotting journalist, because that's really what I think I wanted to do in life. Because ever since then, that's when I've been the happiest, when I've been, you know, jetting off to some foreign place, foreign to me anyway, in order to witness something or be part of something that I could have transmitted to other people. So that was always kind of my thing. I was between art and science and trying to get my head together, and I had a rough childhood. So It was a bad time for me to decide anything. And in the end, I just decided I needed to have a family, so I did that. And that limits you, at least, you know, when you grow up poor, it limits you as far as, you know, being able to jet off around the world like Casey was able to in the 90s. I mean, Casey was fun because he was like the classic 90s slacker who, you know, had a family with money and just got to go and vagabond around the world and take pictures and films and climb mountains and do all that cool stuff. So, you know, I think that was, you know, the fact that he maintained that personality that he had then through his vlog was what really built him an audience and kept people interested, because, you know, most of the people that grew up in the same time frame as he did got real jobs and wore a suit and a tie or worked in a factory or whatever they had to do to make money, and he's still out there having fun. So I think that was a lot of it. But anyway, back to the news. Now, it's not like this hasn't, like I said, been tried before, because first came the blog, and that was awesome. That was going to, you know, just make everybody as powerful as the mainstream news media in their ivory towers and all that. And, you know, to an extent it did, but it's the same as the music industry. You know, the people with the money, which were the ivory tower mainstream establishment places, still dominated, and they still do. But you can, as an indie, really get a voice. It's just hard to get paid for it. That was the downside of it. And like I said, when you got kids and no money behind you, it's hard to be a freelancer and do what I wanted to do. So that's part of my excuse for not doing it. But I did try stuff on the web, and I ended up doing it all for free, but I had a good time. And I ended up getting to go places sometimes and do really interesting things. Like, hold on. Okay, like during that time period, when I was writing about hydrogen and doing experiments, I got an invitation to go to the United Nations and attend a hydrogen conference. And here's my cool little security badge, which I still have stuck to the refrigerator. I don't know why. But anyway, I got to go down into the basement part of the UN and sit there with world leaders, scientific leaders, and listen to a discussion about hydrogen energy, the potential of hydrogen energy, the future of hydrogen energy, and ask some questions. And as a result of that, join in the conversation. And that's just something you can't do sitting at home, you know? I mean, and that's why you need to go places and to do things. And I didn't get paid for that, but I got that experience, and that's something you're not going to get anywhere else. And then later on, a couple years later, when I was still interested in that, but I was also doing more with film promotion and music promotion too. Anyway, I got to go to Washington, D.C. to the Center for American Progress with T. Boone Pickens, the billionaire from Texas, and attend a meeting with him on the energy future of the United States and the world. And I met some interesting people. I met Bill Clinton. I met Al Gore. I met the guy who was the CEO of Walmart at the time, and umpteen other people. And that was because I was doing some stuff online to promote T. Boone Pickens' plan for alternative gas as a domestic supplement or replacement for foreign oil. And that was a great learning experience too. And there again, I got some great pictures and some great video, and I met world leaders and a billionaire. And so, you know, that's part of why I love doing sort of newsy kind of stuff. Anyway, after that, I still wrote some, and I wrote then too. I did a little writing for Filmmaker Magazine, for the magazine and on their blog, and for Current TV, that was an online news portal that was user-generated, and Al Gore and a couple of partners started that. And it had a nice little run, but it wasn't, again, a paid position, and then that eventually went away. And then, kind of at the same time, I was writing for a site called Blog Critics about indie music and film and stuff. And I was in the city, in New York City all week at the time, so I was able to attend, like, something different almost every night. And that was one of the greatest times I ever had in my life. And I'd like to do that again. I'd like to move to New York City. Or the West Coast, one of the two, because I really like independent entertainment, you know, theater, music, film, and now film is easier, and there's much more available since YouTube and Amazon and Netflix and all those guys are there, and they're starting to open up a little bit more to independently produce stuff. It's much more accessible than it used to be, which is really cool. And you don't have to travel as far to see it, but theater and music is still awesome to see live. So there was Blog Critics, that, and then Examiner.com came around, and I tried that for a while, and I was Indie Music Examiner there, or Indie Media Examiner, I forget which. But anyway, I was trying a whole bunch of stuff, and I tried making a sort of a web to TV channel. It was called the Indie Channel, and it was spelled INDETHEINDECHANNEL.com. It kind of sucks right now. It's still there. But it used to have a big video player on the front of it where I could put like a playlist of music videos. And that was when MySpace was still there. It was just when MySpace was kind of starting to die off. And MySpace had great charts of garage bands, undiscovered bands, music you couldn't really hear anywhere else. And I think, most of that same kind of music is on YouTube now. It's just a lot harder to find because nobody really does the charts anymore. But at any rate, okay, so my point was that this has been done before. And then CNN also had iReport, and I was also trying iReport out, and first writing, and then I started transitioning into doing more video, which I was also trying to do on Blog Critics and Examiner. And when I was in the city, I was doing, a lot of video as much as I could, but I couldn't do live video at the time because it was just so technically hard to stream live video from a live performance. And I did a lot of two-way interviews on Skype and stuff on video, and that was really cool. So, I'd like to see, and I'm anxious to see what Casey Neistat and his team develop, because he's talking about news from around the world on whatever the team is developing, like news feeds coming in from all over the world. And that's awesome, because that's also something I've thought about, is that it would be great to have news available that wasn't filtered through, what's going to get us the most views? Well, we don't bother with anything that isn't going to get us views, so it has to be big news. And because of that, which is, I'm sure economically what you need to do, but because of that, I think you miss out on getting a real feel for the rest of the world. You get sort of regional and local news in the U.S., not even in Canada or Mexico. Not where I'm at, and certainly not anywhere in Europe or Russia or Asia or Australia. It's just, you forget they're even there because you hear so little about it, unless it's some big political thing that involves the United States. And I think that's wrong, because I think the web could connect everybody in the world much more than it does now. And especially when companies like Google get sort of a universal translator going, which Google's really close to. And once that's done and you have the ability to live chat with like anybody, and you can live stream to the world and the world can watch you and understand you, and you can have a two-way conversation with anybody in the world, I think, the current power structure in the world would change a lot, because language and borders are two of the big things that keep people separated and willing to go to war with each other, because we really don't understand each other. And it's not hard for the leadership to demonize all the people in another country or say, they need to be collateral damage. And we don't think about it because we don't really know them. We don't understand them. But if the government said the same thing about people down the street, it would be a lot harder, I think, for us to accept. Your friends and family need to die because they're inconvenient. They're collateral damage. There's one guy down there that we need to get, so we're just going to take out the whole block. And I'm sorry your family lives there. I don't think that would fly. But, we will see when we get there, I guess. Because I think we're going to get there, unless people actively block it or delay it somehow. It won't be very long at all before we're there. And I think a station like what Casey Neistat's people could put together would be a great step in that direction. And, if it turns out to be something that one can participate in, I would probably love to participate in it. So I'll just throw that out there. But anyway, so that's what I see as the potential for Casey Neistat's new news network, and I wish him luck with it, and I hope it becomes what it could be, and then it works out. So, good luck with that, and I will see you next time. Stay cool. Goodbye.